This is M6CEB. Just turn that down. Just wanted to do a quick sort of first impressions stroke review of this radio. Just let me turn that down a bit more. So yeah, I've had it a week now. I've had it as a base station for a couple of days, and it's been sort of mobile ever since. So I basically just wanted to hop on quickly in the car and just kind of give you an idea of sort of my impressions of it. It's an amazing radio, absolutely love it, I think it's fantastic. The only downside, I would say, first, is that the microphone plugs into the base of the transceiver, not in the head unit. You do get a separation kit with it, so you can separate the head unit from the transceiver. And I've run that all the way down. The only thing is, it's 3 meters long, excuse me, which is about probably a little bit short on what I'll really need and probably what everyone will need. 3 meters is very short for the separation kit if you're using it in the car and you want to run it around all your bits and pieces. And I think that's them being cheeky. I think they want you to have to buy the 5 meter that they sell. I got the 5 meter one for about a tenner, I think it was, on eBay. You know, it said it was a genuine one, but it works anyway, so it's not a problem. But the microphone, that goes into the transceiver as well, like the separation kit. On, say, a Yaesu FT7900, the microphone would go into the side of your head unit, so that when you're, you know, obviously you would only need to have a separation kit for the head unit, and the microphone would just go in the side. Now, luckily, I prefer it this way, because I just had to buy a microphone extension kit for about another tenner, or whatever it was, which then allows me to have this mic cable running under my seat, rather than having it dangling it down from there. So, in a way, it's worked out for the best. The display is absolutely awesome. The GPS is, it's also got the GPS all, that'll flash until it finds the satellite. It's found it now, and it's it, that'll just tell you miles per hour, give you the head in, and when you're using APRS, obviously you can, you know, transmit your beacon and also put you in GM mode, which means that any stations near you that are also transmitting APRS will then come through on my display here. We don't have too many people around at my location that use APRS, so it's not something I'm overly concerned about using, although I have tried it. So if I go, that's my APRS. I've just programmed it in a memory channel there. This says it is a dual watch, so you can have, say, whatever channel you want, and then have a home channel, and it'll check that home channel every few seconds, and it'll keep blipping back, which is great. So you can dual watch, but for the APRS, what tends to happen with me, if I press it now, hold that down, you'll see it go into dual watch, and you'll see it flicking. Oh, sorry, APRS is my other channel, as a home channel. So if I put it on that, it should flick to APRS. There you go. So maybe I need to reverse it round. But what I've found is, when it transmits the beacon, it just opens the repeater up. So that's what happens with that. So let me just turn that off. There we go. So I need to look at that, but it does have APRS, and I did try it when I first got the radio, and it works great. I haven't really played with it since. I've been actually mobile when you actually would use it. But I've found, obviously, you can't use the radio when you're using APRS, so I couldn't, like, have a chat or listen out for something else that's going on. You're basically just doing APRS when you've set it up to do that. So it's not really for me, I think. I think the 400 version of this radio does have a dual system completely, so you can APRS and monitor other stations at the exact same time. So that has got it at an edge on this. But this, I think, was released as a lot cheaper. It is a hell of a lot cheaper as well. And I think it still has most of the features, if not all of them. So it's worked out perfectly for me. So yeah, just go into the settings. If you hold down this one, these are some of the settings. APRS, you can turn the modem on and off. So if I go into it, There you go, APRS modem. I would then turn that on, come back, just press back, and then back again. And then there you go, the little round circle there is on APRS. So if we put it onto the channel, it should send a beacon. That's the plan, but I'm not 100%. So yeah, it's got YZX there. My local node, let me just turn this this APRS beaconing off. I don't want it to start opening up stuff. Just turn that off. You see the circle's gone now. But if I go, this is my nearest Fusion node. That is the downside of Fusion, for me anyway. There's just not enough repeaters and nodes that are usable to me. There's only one node that's connected to YZX and only one repeater that's digital, but it's not connected to YZX. So if it wasn't for this guy, Dave M0AUT, I would be stuffed. I wouldn't be able to get on YZX whatsoever. So basically this you just hold down. I'm not in range now, so it won't work, but if I just hold that down, there you go, it's transmitting, and then it would be waiting for the signal back from the node or repeater, and then it would display at the top what room you're in, and then you would then go into the menu of the node and you can change the room to whatever you want, you know, as long as the repeater keeper is okay with you changing his settings. Usually they are if you put them back to how they were when you found them. So they're not too bothered about it usually, but it's always best to check. So this is just waiting for a signal to come back. It won't get it because I'm not in range, and then that's it, now it's finished, it's come back. So yeah, it's very easy to program. I've found it absolutely really really easy. For example, if I just go off here now onto, this is the VFO memory button, so there you go, I'm into the VFO now. And then if I just use my keypad and put one for, oh sorry, wrong one. One for, I'm doing it again. One for 5450, and I wanted to save that. You can use these program keys on here, so you can change. I think you can change them, but I haven't bothered. So you see, it's that the mode's changing from FM. I think that's an auto setting where it would detect whether the signal comes through as FM or digital and change it accordingly. If you press it again, that is actually digital, where it splits the 12.5 kc step for half of it voice, half of it data, so you can get call sign information of the other station and distance from them. If you press it again, that's voice. I think it's voice wide, I think they call that, where it uses the full 12.5 kc just for voice, so you get like an ultra, you know, brilliant voice come through. And then FM, so you can just use it as your 270, excuse me, analog radio. So this is why I got this radio. I wanted a 270 for the car, and I was going to get the FT7900. That's what I was going to get, but for just a little bit more, I could have got a 270 radio, i.e. this one, with digital Fusion as a bonus. So I thought, you know, even if I don't use the Fusion, for a few quid extra while I had it, it made sense for me to do it, so I did it. And I have been able to play on Fusion, and it's amazing. So I definitely recommend Fusion as well. But like I was saying about the memory channels, say if I wanted to store this, you would just hold down your VFO memory button. So you hold it, and then this is that where you can add it into it. And the next available is 16. And then you would then hit tag. You can tag it, come out of it, and it would then save it. It's that simple. And if you've got... and you know, your CTCSS, and it does automatic repeater shift as well. It's just all in the settings. You just hold down your settings. I can't remember which one's which. I think config will give you... I think config will give you... Yeah, it would give you the automatic repeater shift. I don't know why it keeps coming out there. And then also you can go in and go to signalling, and that will give you your CTCSS information that you can program in, and then it would be in, and then just go back to VFO, and there's the repeaters. You can use the up and down mics buttons on the keypad to search. I've got this connected to obviously the speaker, turn it down a bit, is located on the main body of the unit. I've got that in the boot now, so it does have an auxiliary out port on it, and I've used that to, as you can see, I've got my Kenwood SP230 down there, so that I can have half decent audio coming through. So these lights here, if it receives an FM signal, they both light up green. If it receives a digital signal, you'll get a green one at the top and a blue one at the bottom. And then if you're transmitting on FM, they will both be red. And if you're transmitting on digital, the top one will be red and the bottom one will be blue, I think. So basically the bottom one being blue is a quick way of looking at it really quick to know whether you're in digital or FM. And you can, this bit where it says the volts, you can change that to give you the date and time or the other band. So you could have your UHF here and VHF at the top, and then just keep swapping it with the band button. But I like to read the volts, because obviously being mobile and I don't always have the car running, it's nice to keep an eye on what's going on there. And obviously this is the GPS side of things. You can, I think you can just turn it off if you don't want to have that bit, but it doesn't do it any harm in my opinion. It always tells you what direction you're going in, and it's always handy to know, I suppose. And then this is the GM button, so if you hold that, this is bare. I think you can leave messages on repeaters and stuff, I think. But as I say, it's something I'm going to have a proper play with when I can. And then you just click it across and it'll keep scanning. So over to the microphone, it's the MH48 microphone. It's brilliant, I've had some really good reports on it. Brilliant, everything PTT is very nice. Got an up and down buttons on the top, a lamp button and a key lock button. You've got your DTMF obviously, and these are programmable buttons. You're probably familiar with the Yaesu mics. But yeah, absolutely brilliant microphone. So yeah, that's kind of it. I just wanted to do a bit of a first impression really. Just in case you were sort of wanting to think about getting it. I know there's not much about this radio online. Can you see, obviously, it's got an SD card in it as well. Because you can download photos and messages off repeaters and people's nodes that, you know, people leave for everybody. So you can put an SD card in. I'm not sure what size it goes up to, but I've got a 16 gig in there, which is more than enough, in my opinion. And you've also got there the repeater shift and the CTCSS encode. Excuse me. And that's it, really. I'm trying to think. Got your transmit power, this'll do. This is the other downside. It'll do. It's got low, medium and high power. And low is 5 watts, medium is 20 watts, and high is 50 watts. So for me as an M6, I can only use the low setting, and I'm losing 5 watts, if you will. I can't, there isn't a 10 watt setting. So I can only put out 5 watts at best. It would have been good if they would have had like the 7900 version where you've got a 10 watt option. So that is a bit of a negative. So I find 5 watts fine. I mean, I'm on a Watson Super Gainer at the moment, which has got, I think it's got a 7 dB gain on 77s and a 5.5 on 2, I think. And it does do amazingly well. And I think if you're going to make the trip with 5 watts, then 10 watts probably wouldn't, you know, make too much of a difference, in I suppose. But I haven't had any problem at all. It's very sensitive, gets out great. It looks amazing. It comes on this like little stand. If I just go around there, comes on this like stand, and I've just cable tied it up to these here, and then that's the separation cable up there, and that just goes around the top. down the A pillar, and then down there all the way into the back seat. If I push that forward, you can see the power cable there going into the boot and the separation cable, and I've got the mic cable on the other side. Oh, noisy motorbike. So yeah, that's it really. I'm trying to think if there's anything I've sort of missed out. I only really wanted to do a bit of a, you know, a bit of a sort of first impressions really. But there you go, that's how it's coming through. See, this is my local digital repeater, GB3RF. It's not connected to WiseX, so I can't use the internet on it. But if I now put it using my microphone button, and then if you watch there, and I put it into digital mode, and now I key up, see, it's received it. It transmitted with blue on the bottom, so it was in digital, and then I got the pip back to let me know I'd got in. There you go. And then if I then put it back on FM, there you go, now it's on FM. There you go, and that's in FM. So I love Fusion, think it's brilliant, love the radio. I'll do a proper in-depth review. Oh yeah, and you get the Yaesu sticker with it that's proudly on the car there. But yeah, I'll do a proper review when I can get into it a bit better. I'll just show you my antenna dead quick before I wrap it up. And there's my super gainer. I might as well show you the setup in the boot in case you haven't seen it. There it is. Someone did say, why didn't I put it in the little area in the side there? But there's nothing solid behind it without, as you can see, it's not the best of places to put it without having to sort of drill loads of holes and stuff. So there's the base unit, antenna obviously there, the external speaker mic there, power cable, connector, and then the front, you put your SD card in the front, you've got your separation cable and your mic extension cable, and the programming cable comes with it as well for this radio, and I've just left that in the socket just to keep it safe with the radio, and that's it really. So just go back in the car. So that's it. So yeah, I'll do a proper video when I can, and hope you enjoyed the video. Please leave a comment, subscribe, you know, like it if you like it, and don't like it if you don't. So thank you very much, and I hope this has been a help to anybody, and hope you enjoy the radio. If you get it, I'd certainly recommend it. I certainly recommend Fusion. I've had a play on DMR as well, and Fusion, in my opinion, is better than DMR, but each to their own. So 73, thanks very much for watching the video, and hope to catch you on the bands. 73 for now, Mike 6, Charlie Echo Bravo.